Hi students, today we are going to study practice set 6.2 from the lesson trigonometry, which is the last practice set from the lesson trigonometry, and it is depend upon the examples based on heights and distances. And here we have to use the concept line of vision, angle of elevation and angle of deep region. We have to use these three concepts for solving the word problems. And from the practice set 6.2, we have the first example. A person is standing at a distance of 80 meter from a church looking at its top. The angle of elevation made is of 45 degree. Find the height of the church. Find the height of the church. We have given a person. In this example, we have given a person which is 80 meter away from a church, and he looks at the top of the church and he finds the angle of elevation of 45 degree there. So, how much is the distance between the church and that person? So, while solving the word problems in the trigonometry, first we have to draw the diagram according to the given information. We have to draw a diagram according to the given information. Then we have to write the description of that diagram. In that diagram, the segments and the vertices indicates which terms or indicates which objects that we have to describe there. And then we have to write the solution. See the three steps. In the first step, we have to draw the diagram according to the given information into the question. In the second step, we have to write the description of that diagram, and into the third step, we have to solve the example. So, here we will first draw the diagram. For drawing the diagram, we have to use the line segments and the vertices. For the objects in that example, here we have given there is a church. So, we will represent that church by a segment. Let it be a church. We will represent this segment AB. This segment AB is a church. From that church, a person is 80 meter away. From that church, a person is 80 meter away. So, from this church, suppose that person is here. We will represent that person by using the point C. This point C represents a person. And if this person observes the top of the church, then it is found that there is angle of elevation of 45 degree. We get angle of elevation of 45 degree if that person observes the top of the church. And already I told you two things. The first one, each and every object is always perpendicular to the ground or floor that we have to consider. And number two, see here we have given a person and we represent that person by using a point. And already I told you, we have to neglect the height of the person. We have to neglect the height of the person in the examples. Sometimes we have to consider the height. But in that example, you have given the information like that, whether we have to consider the height of that person or we do not have to consider the height of person. And if the no information is given there, then we have to neglect the height of that person, and here we have to neglect the height of that person. We represent that person by using a point C. Now we complete, we draw a diagram representing the situation, and now here we have to describe the diagram. In this diagram, which segment or which point represents which object, that we have to describe here. In this diagram, seg AB
Seg AB is a church. We represent the church by using the segment AB. Here point C, that is a person. Point C represents a person. Point C is a person. We represent the person by using the point C. These two things are important. And if you want to write that BC, what is BC? Seg BC represents the distance between the person and church. The seg BC represents the distance between the person and the church. So here you can write seg BC, distance between the person and church. That is not necessary to write. That is not too important. That is the given information. This is given. BC is equal to 80 meter. That is given information. But if you want to write that here, you can write. And if you do not write, we have to represent the important things in this description. And suppose you write, then it will be work that you can write here seg BC is distance between, seg BC is distance between person and church. So this is all about the description. First step, we have to draw the diagram according to the given situation. Second step, we have to write the description. And then we have to write the actual solution. We have to solve the example. Now here easily you can tell me the answer that if the distance between the person and church is 80 meter, then the height of the church is also 80 meter. Here you can easily tell me the answer. Anyone can tell me the answer that height of the church is 80 meter. How it is? How the height of the church is 80 meter? See, this is right angle triangle. One angle measures 45 degree. This is right angle. So definitely it is 45 degree. This is isosceles right angle triangle. And if this side measures 80 meter, then definitely this side measures 80 meter. But we have to write the solution here. You cannot directly write that the height of the church is 80 meter. We have to write, and using the trigonometric concepts, using the trigonometric ratio, you cannot use the 45 degree, 90 degree triangles theorem there. We have to use the trigonometric concepts, trigonometric ratios there. So here we have triangle ABC, in right angle triangle ABC, in right angle triangle ABC, angle B is equal to 90 degree, angle C is equal to 45 degree, and we have BC is equal to 80 meter. And what we have to find? We have to find AB, that is the height of the church that we have to find. Now here, see the angle which we have given, that is angle C, which is the angle of elevation. If a person observes above the horizontal line, then that angle is said to be angle of elevation. And here we know the adjacent side of the angle. We know the adjacent side of the angle, and we have to find the opposite side of the angle. That is very important thing. What information we have and what we have to find. Here we have given the adjacent side of this angle, and we have to find the opposite side of the angle. So which ratio we need to find here, or which ratio is we can get from adjacent side and opposite side? We have two ratios, either tan or cot. You can use tan ratio or you can use cot ratio. So here we will use any one ratio, because both the ratios are related with the opposite side and adjacent side, that is tan ratio and cot ratio. So here we will use tan ratio of angle 45 degree. So we will write here tan 45 degree is equals to, why we choose the tan ratio, that is very important thing. This is very easy. Plotting a diagram, drawing a diagram, that is easy. describing a diagram, that is also easy. But here important thing, we have to get the ratio, we have to use the trigonometric ratio. We have 6 ratios in all, so which ratio we have to use there? And here we knows the adjacent side, and we have to find the opposite side. We use tan ratio of angle 45 degree. If this angle given 30 degree, then we can write tan 30 degree. If this angle measures 60 degree, then we will write tan 60 degree. Here it is given that this angle measures 45 degree, so we write tan 45 degree. And according to diagram, tan 45 is equal to AB upon BC. So here we write AB upon BC, and that is from the figure by the definition. Now we can put the values, tan 45 is 1. The value of tan 45 is 1 according to trigonometric table. Tan 45 is 1. AB we have to find upon AC 80. Sorry, BC is 80 meter. Now the thing is there in the denominator, means we have 1 here. Now take the cross multiplication. AB into 1 is AB. That is equal to 80 into 1 is 80, and the unit is meter. So the final answer, the question we have given, that is find the height of the church. The answer is height of the church is 80 meters. So you can write the answer here. Therefore, height of the church is 80 meters. So this is all about the first word example from the practice set 6.2, and it is too easy. Just remember, in the first step we have to draw the diagram, in the second step we have to write the description of that diagram, and into the third step we have to write the information which we have available here, and then you have to select the trigonometric ratio, and we have to find the value which we have to find or which we required. So we will take the next example, second example. Second example from practice set 6.2. From a lighthouse, from the top of the lighthouse, an observer is looking at a ship. From the top of the lighthouse, an observer is looking at a ship, making an angle of depression of 60 degree. If the height of the lighthouse, if the height of the lighthouse is 90 meter, if the height of the lighthouse is 90 meter, then how long is that ship from the lighthouse? Then how long is that ship from the lighthouse? And we have given the value of square root of 3, that is 1.73. We have given the value of root 3, that is 1.73. Now here look at the situation or the condition. We have given a lighthouse. In the first step we have to draw the diagram. It is given that we have a lighthouse. On the top of the lighthouse, observer is there. At this point, observer is there at the top of the lighthouse. Let it be lighthouse, we will represent it as PQ, that is lighthouse. The observer is there on the top of the lighthouse, and he observes a ship which is coming to the lighthouse. He observes a ship which is coming to the lighthouse. So here we will take ship. This point represents ship or a boat, you can say. This point R representing the ship or the boat. If this observer looks at this ship, the angle of depression is made of 60 degree. Here we have to think carefully. Angle of depression is made there. It means that the observer looks below the horizontal line. See, observer is here and this is the horizontal line. It is very important thing. Observer is here on the top of the lighthouse, and this is the horizontal line for that observer. And now he looks below the horizontal line and measure the angle made is of 60 degree. This is very important thing. This segment PQ is lighthouse, which is definitely perpendicular to the ground or floor. Observer is there on the top of the lighthouse, that is point Q represents the observer and point R represents the ship or a boat. If this observer looks at this ship, the angle of depression of 60 degree is there. That is very important. Angle of depression. This angle is not having measurement 60 degree. Some students representing this angle 60 degree. Actually, the angle made between the horizontal line and the line of vision. This is the line of vision and this is the horizontal line. And that is always parallel to the horizontal, or you can say floor, or you can say ground level. Now here this angle measures 60 degree. Now anybody can say that if this angle measures 60 degree, then this angle is also 60 degree. And the reason behind it is these two lines are parallel to each other and this is the transversal. And these two are the alternate angles made by a transversal of two parallel lines. So this angle congruent, this angle. So we will take one more point here to read the name of this angle and we will represent that point by S. So this is the diagram. According to the situation, this is the diagram. In this diagram, PQ is, say PQ is lighthouse, point Q is an observer, point R is a ship. And we have to find the distance. How far is that ship from the lighthouse? We have to find the distance between ship and lighthouse. And this is given 90 meter. Height of the lighthouse is given 90 meters. And now we have to find this segment PR. So first we, in the first step, we have to draw the diagram and we drew it. And now we have to describe this diagram. So we have to write the description here. Seg PQ is a lighthouse. Then point Q is an observer and this segment we have to find. So you have to describe this as seg PR, distance between lighthouse and ship. Distance between lighthouse and ship. So this is all about the description. This is a diagram, this is description. And now we have to write the measurements which we have available here. See, this is in right angle triangle PQR, or in the above figure, see this angle is given into the example angle of elevation QSQR, that is 60 degree. And if this angle measures 60 degree, then you can certainly say that this angle also measures 60 degree. And the reason behind it is alternate angles made by the transversal of two parallel lines. So here you will write angle SQR is equals to angle QRP is equals to 60 degree, and the reason is alternate angles theorem. These two lines are parallel and this is their transversal. So these two angles are alternate angles, and alternate angles are congruent if a transversal is intersecting the two parallel lines. Then we have PQ is equal to 90 meters, or you can write angle P is equal to 90 degree first. Then we have PQ is equal to 90 meters, and we have to find PR.
we have to find PR.
Now see, we know this angle 60 degree, this angle measures 60 degree. We know the side opposite to angle and we have to find the side up adjacent to angle. We know the side opposite to this angle and we have to find the side adjacent to this angle. So which ratio we have to use? Again we have two choices, that is tan or cot. That is tan or cot. So we will write here tan ratio again is tan 60 degree is equal to, that is very important to use the trigonometric ratio there. You cannot use 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree triangles theorem there. We have to use the trigonometric concept only there. We have to use the trigonometric ratio only. So here we are writing tan 60 degree, tan 60 degree. How you can write tan? Tan is opposite side upon adjacent side, that is PQ upon PR. So tan 60 is equal to PQ upon PR. Put the values there. According to trigonometric table, tan 60 is root 3. Value of tan 60 is root 3. Nothing is there in the denominator, means we have 1 there. Then PQ, how much is the value of PQ? It is 90 upon, we have to find PR. Now take the cross multiplications. PR multiplied by root 3 is equal to 90. Root 3 into PR is equal to 90. Now transfer this root 3 to the right side. We'll see, we have root 3 into PR is equal to 90. We will transfer this root 3 to the right side. We will get 90 upon root 3. Now we have to rationalize the denominator. Since the denominator is irrational, it is 90 multiplied by root 3 upon root 3 multiplied by root 3, this is PR is equal to 90 into root 3 divided by 3. This is divide 90 by 3, we will get 30. So we have PR is equal to 30 root 3, but the value of root 3 is given as 1.73. So we have to use that value here. This is PR is equal to 30 multiplied by 1.73. and the multiplication is 51.90 meters. So you can write it as PR is equal to 51.9 meters. Now you can write the final answer into the words. Therefore, distance between the ship and lighthouse is 51.9 meters. This is all about the second example. We will take third example.